The eyes of Limousin-minded people worldwide will focus on Britain in the first 2 weeks of August 2004, as the British Limousin Cattle Society hosts the International Limousin Congress, ILC. The Congress delegates will view at first hand just how and why Limousin has become the most popular cattle breed in Britain. Amazingly, the first Limousins to tread British soil only arrived from France in 1970, just over 30 short years ago. By early 2002, official figures confirmed that Limousin is the most popular cattle sire of all breeds in the land, beef or dairy. During the Congress, you'll find out why. Events will include one of the largest ever British shows of Limousin-blooded cattle, an elite sale of hand-picked stock and genetic material, a conference giving the exchange of worldwide Limousin information, plus, of course, visits to pedigree and commercial herds to show British Limousins in their working environment, doing what they do best, producing great cattle and great beef. For the early part of the Congress, delegates will be based in glorious Perthshire, one of Scotland's most scenic counties. Here you'll visit Britain's largest commercial Limousin beef producing herd, grazing in the foothills of the majestic Grampian Mountains. In this herd you'll see hundreds of Limousin-sired females, proving that this is truly a double-barreled breed, with the cows reliably producing and rearing tip-top quality Limousin-sired beef calves year after year. Many commercial beef breeders throughout Britain are now insisting their female replacements are Limousin crosses. Farmers recognize good beef on the hoof, but the vital measure is the quality of the meat on the butcher's block. So, just how does Limousin beef rate with British retail butchers?
This is the business. The quality of the meat is self-evident. It's got a beautiful covering of fat on it, not too thick, just enough to give it flavouring. It has a nice level of marbling. Both of these things will help to ensure good eating quality. The rib roast is similar. Now that's on the bone, a fabulous roast for anybody to take home. But again, you need to have the marbling, a covering of fat, the assurance of good husbandry on the farm. All these things lend themselves to the final eating quality of a product.
Still in Scotland, you'll also visit pedigree herds in the Royal Borough of Stirling, home of William Wallace, the 13th century Scottish hero, and inspiration for Mel Gibson's epic film, Braveheart. On August 4th, you'll travel to Edinburgh, Scotland's historic capital city, and the Royal Highland Showground, where you'll attend Britain's annual National Specialist Beef event. The highlight of the day will be one of the largest competitive shows of pedigree and commercial Limousin cattle ever seen in Britain. After 4 days of Limousin cattle and 4 nights of Scottish fun, when you will surely come face to face with kilts, bagpipes and yes, even a real haggis, you'll cross the English border into Cumbria, a dramatic land of lakes and mountains. Here you'll visit a pedigree herd before heading into Carlisle Livestock Auction Market, the Limousin's main British sales centre, for an elite sale of exceptional, carefully selected pedigree cattle, semen and embryos. In 2002, in this sale ring, records were created by Limousins, including a then record average for any breed of £4,375 for 147 bulls. That was in 2002. On Valentine's Day 2003, however, worldwide Limousin history was made in Carlisle. The ringside was packed solid for the February sale, as Graham Sampson, the champion from the previous evening's show, took his turn in the sale ring. There had been much pre-sale interest in this 17-month-old bull, and the bidding opened at 20,000 guineas, a ploy to scare off the opposition, but it didn't work. After a bidding duel between several bidders inside and outside the ring, the auctioneer finally brought his hammer down at 55,000 guineas, a new world Limousin record price. The buyer was Dougie Edgar of the Shire herd. We can't promise you another world record price at the ILC sale in 2004, but of course you're more than welcome to pay one if you want to. The day after the sale at the conference, you will hear technical and hands-on cattleman information on what our glorious breed is doing throughout the beef world. The following day, you head east to the rugged border county of Northumberland to visit one of England's biggest team of pedigree Limousin bulls working in a commercial herd. There's some special Limousin history here too. This enterprise is run by the two sons of Shorus Robertson, the very first British farmer to apply to import Limousin bulls from France. From here, you head southwest to Chatsworth Estate, home of the Duke and Duchess of Devonshire, and of course, an impressive commercial herd of Limousins, producing beef for Chatsworth's own chain of farm shops. That evening, more fun, food and festivity at the closing ceremony. But please, don't go yet. There's a three-day post-conference tour which takes you to Wales, the land of song, birthplace of some fine rugby players, and home to a cattle industry which has embraced the Limousin breed. From your base amidst the heather-clad hills of Mid Wales, you cross the English border into the rolling meadows of Herefordshire and Shropshire. For every day of your ILC visit, there will be a night of great social entertainment, where you can let your hair down and show everybody just whose rumps really are trumps. And of course, all along the way, you'll be able to enjoy and savour the many different flavours of our British history, architecture and culture. To Limousin people all around the world, we in Britain extend a very warm welcome to you to view our cattle, meet our people and see our land. So please, don't hesitate. Make an August 2004 date to visit Britain, where Limousins dominate.